you've been seeing this industry growing from very close quarters. We are in a slowdown. 5 years back, we were in a slowdown. Then when at the beginning of this century, there was another slowdown. How do you actually rate these different phases of slowdown?
Well, you know, I think pre-80s, let's say pre-90s, Indian auto component industry was more dependent on the commercial vehicle sector than the passenger car sector. Because earlier there was only Hindustan Motors and Premiers, very few production. And the value of that production was not so high. But the truck industry, which was led by Tata's and Ashok Leyland, actually created a lot of component manufacturing companies. However, there was not that emphasis on quality that came about with passenger car industry. So I've seen in the 80s, tremendous slowdown in the truck industry when a lot of us created huge capacities and then there was no market. Why has the automotive and passenger car industry grown? It's because people are getting jobs. And if you get a job, you know you can pay a part of it as an EMI. Yeah. So it becomes worthwhile to, everybody wants to own a car. There's nobody I've met who doesn't want a car. Everybody wants a car. So people buy cars because the environment is good. People are getting jobs and people know in this country, you got a job, more jobs are available, you'll jump a job and you'll get a better salary so you can buy a better car or exchange it for a better car. So I think that environmental issues, psychological issues play also, in my view, at least 50%. I think interest rates being higher, people say, okay, if I can't pay 10,000 rupees, maybe I can pay 9,000 rupees, I'll still want a car. Yeah. So interest rates most certainly play a role. But if you look at every time there has been a slowdown, there's been a different reason for it. I think the fact that people are not seeing the economy grow, yeah, and frankly, that is, in my view, has got nothing to do with the global fact. They're all our own doings. We need to attract investments. We're not doing the right things to attract investments. But if you look at the fact that money, it's not that it's not available. Money is available. People can find money to buy cars, irrespective of the interest rate. The thing that is not happening is that there are no jobs being created. You know, I was hoping that what Dr. Manmohan Singh said earlier this year, that he's going to personally monitor the big infrastructure projects, that that implementation needs to be focused on. Because I think once that gets going, I think you'll see jobs getting created, you'll see downstream industries beginning to do well, whether it's steel or cement and construction industry, jobs getting created, tractors required or earth-moving equipment required, cars required. That's really the kind of thing that needs to continue.
So how badly are you hit?
Well, frankly, in our own group, we're not hit to the extent that the industry is hit. And yes, yesterday, sir, I was attending one of our company's board meetings, Mahindra Sona, and I saw the results there. They've grown by 7% despite every sector that they supply to has gone down. And the reason is that they're on the right platforms, on the right vehicles, so that those vehicles are growing, yeah. And they've gotten some new business. So industry, I mean, I look at Sona Okegawa, they've grown by 12%. Yeah. Look at Sona Koyo, they've grown over from last year, Sona Koyo Group. Yeah. So we've grown.
Maruti getting into LCV, you expect a lot of business
from
that?
Yeah, we will get business from that.
How big will that be?
Well, it'll depend how fast it'll grow. But I think we're all seeing a trend of everybody getting into that mid-segment, yeah, above the passenger car, below the SUV. There is a passenger vehicle possible, there's a commercial vehicle that's possible, and that's available in this country. I mean, I think Tata's with Ace demonstrated that you could have a small vehicle which could be used as a truck, small truck could be used as a small passenger carrier, etc. So I think there are various segments that the auto industry is creating.
And sir, also I believe you are in the process of moving, shifting out of the Gurgaon plant to, yeah, three other locations. How's, yeah, that coming up?
You know, I believe that every odd years, 25 to 30 years, you need to change the location you're in. Reason is, you get complacent with old things that are going on in the same place. You need to create something new. 3 years ago, we took a decision that we need to move out of Gurgaon, which is now 25 years old. We need to move to Darukheda, which is only a few 20 odd kilometers away. We've got three locations there, totally adding up to about 20 odd acres. Yeah. Here we have got about 12 acres of land, utilizing about 7-8. So we said, let's move to these new locations and let's separate the column lines, the pinion lines and so on and so forth, so that we get more economies of scale. Coupled with that, our collaborators, JTEC, have actually now come out with a new manufacturing system, what they call the fishbone system, which is different from the just-in-time delivery system. And they believe just-in-time delivery is more useful for car makers or automakers, and that fishbone is more useful for component makers. And we've actually seen almost 12% productivity improvement.
Sir, but this property would be at a very premium rate at the moment.
Well, look, I don't know what its value is. I don't know what the zoning laws are. I don't think we did it because of a property play, but most certainly it gives us a land bank, which at the appropriate time we will examine. And then we will see what the situation is. So I'm not saying that we need to do this for some motive of being in the real estate business. I don't think we'll ever get into the real estate business. But most certainly we will use the funds that we have for further business expansions.
Maybe getting into hospitality altogether would make sense?
I don't think so. I think we're in the manufacturing business. We'll stick to manufacturing. We are today we've got three plants in Dharukheda. We've got one in Sanand. We've got one in Chennai for Sona Koyo. For GSAI, we've got plants in Bawal, in Bangalore and in Chennai. For Sona Fuji, we have a plant in Bawal. So I think we've got enough manufacturing expertise, bandwidth, that we should really stick to manufacturing. Automotive industry is something we know very well. Yeah, we need to get into maybe more geographies over a period of time, like Sona Okegawa and Mahindra Sona are doing. Sona Koyo has been limited to the Indian automotive space, and we have now discussed with our partners that we will support them in overseas markets with certain products. And I think that will give us the growth aspirations that we have.
Sir, there's another question on your overseas plans. You've been more focused on joint venture partnership, and Koyo has been a great partner for you.
Absolutely.
But has there been any sort of focus on the inorganic growth?
Well, we did one. Yeah. We did a huge one in the heydays of 2007-2008.
But there hasn't been a happy...
No, it's been a very happy. I think, yeah, you're right that initially, because of the financial crisis, there was a huge slump in Europe and in the US. We have one plant in the US as well. But I'm happy to tell you the US plant is rocking right now. I mean, it wants more and more capital, which we don't have to give it. And therefore, they're using India as a sourcing base. Our US company is using our Indian company as a sourcing base. So we're supplying through them. We're supporting them. In Germany, we had a problem because of the structure of the company at that point of time. We've restructured it to a fair extent, where our debt has come down substantially. And the businesses are doing well. We have done one product which a company like Daimler is working with us on developing newer axles along with them. Their designs, we're providing the gearing for it. And I think once that is confirmed and launched, we will get a huge stickiness with the other customers because of our new technology product.
Maruti takes credit, and they claim that, you know, we literally handled all the tier 1 vendors which are now.
Absolutely true.
And they also complain that tier 1 vendors have not been able to, you know, spoon feed the tier
Hold
2
hands.
Or tier 3 vendors.
Well, let me tell you, Maruti can't say that about us because they've awarded us. We have developed our tier 2, tier 3. Look, tier 2, tier 3 businesses and their owners, it's really the owners that need to change. A lot of owners still have the old psyche that I've invested, therefore I must make profits. Not realizing profits will come out of cost savings, not out of just being in business. Yeah, and cost savings will come out of productivity improvements, not just by saying that, you know, I'm here, tell me what I should do. So, which means an involvement. Yeah, Maruti has started this MACE, which really helps a lot of the auto component industry. We have started what we call a VSME program, Visionary Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises, where we've got a whole department that actually works with the supply chain to improve their productivity and their productivity of supplies to us. Yeah? With that process, we believe that we could help them.